Chess Pokututa, Krista Krenko, Yakovka.
Yes, I bet you have.
Jessica, welcome back to Smuggler's Cantina. And today we're going to be talking about The Mandalorian. The pilot episode came out, and I finally was able to get right through the technical difficulties that Disney Plus is having right now. Not exactly an impressive launch, guys. Anyway, it's interesting. Again, some of the spoilers, Jason Ward talking to you, were wrong. Yes, there's a baby at the end, but it is not a human baby. Thank Yoda at the age of 100. Or 50. All right. Very interesting. Yes, this will be spoilers. Okay, there will be spoilers. I just spoiled a little bit. It starts out where he's walks into a bar. All right. Music isn't anything like what we're used to in Star Wars, but it fits the Western motif because this is a Western. He walks into a bar and gets into a fight with these guys that are torturing some other alien. Kills them both. Put it this way, I'm shocked that Disney would allow this to be on their show or on their streaming service because it is definitely not for little kids, all right? This is definitely not a Cinderella territory, all right? There's some violent shit in this. I mean, not kidding. Anyway, that part's very violent. Captures the bounty. Finally gets him to his ship. And the guy tries to escape. He carbon freezes him. Carbon freeze is on the ship. It's all very interesting to me. Because there is a theory out there that Rey was kidnapped and put into carbonite. Which, you know, if you're putting a carbonite, you are, we know what the after effects are. Loss of short-term and long-term memory. Vomiting. Dizziness. Blindness, temporary blindness. And at times, death. So he's got a carbon freezing chamber in there. He's already got, I think, 3 or 4 poor bastards that he's already captured. So he gets this, what's its name into this thing, and he takes it out. Gets to where they're going. Carl Weathers pays him. Then he goes and he meets this Werner Herzog, who, and this is where it gets very interesting, and I think this is the connection too, the Skywalker saga. Now, there is a rumor, and this is connected to the Imperial Remnant. Remember, the show takes 5 years. Takes place 5 years after the rise of Skywalker, or the Return of the Jedi. Ben Solo should be about 4 or 5 years, 4 years old. And this guy, Werner Herzog, who's a Imperial whatever, is there, and he basically gets the Mandalorian, whatever his name is, to take this bounty. There's no bounty fob on it. All there is a 4-digit code. It's 50 years old, which is the key that it's not a human. And there's no name attached. It's just a direction fob that he has to follow. This doctor comes out, one of those squirrely little geeky boys. Oh my God, he's supposed to come in alive. And there are Imperial troops sitting there, broken down stormtroopers. What's going on here? We'll get in deeper. What I think is happening here is that we are getting to witness the Empire. What they're doing is they're kidnapping the members of the children of a high-ranking alliance officials or high-ranking whatever I'm gonna say Yoda baby is probably maybe a member of Yoda's, a descendant of Yoda's family. I don't know, but that's the, but that is that the bounty that the Mandalorian has. And basically after going to where this encampment was, where the kid is being protected, he has to fight his way in with it with this droid, a bounty droid, IG-66. And then they finally get to the kid after a big fight, and he basically has to kill the droid because the droid doesn't care if he kills the baby or not. Here's the deal. If they're cloning people, and this could be something that the Empire, the Imperial Remnants is doing. Remember, Darth Emo does say, my clone armies will do better in TFA. There's a connection here to the Skywalker saga. So, I'm thinking we need to watch part two. This is not a bad show. I am not disappointed. It was a little jumpy. It's not what you're used to, but you feel like you're in a Star Wars movie. You get that sort of adrenaline rush that you get when you're actually watching something that harkens back to the days when Star Wars actually meant something. Okay. So I say, if you want to torrent it, torrent it. If you want to stream it, stream it. You want to buy the service until it's over, the first season, be my guest. I'm probably going to keep it till the first season's over. And we'll see where it goes, where it takes us. And as far as I'm concerned, this is going to be, this is a very interesting lead-in to what could be surrounding Rey's story in the Rise of Skywalker. Because I do see a connection to be, to, there's something about it that the kidnapping of children or the Imperial Remnant in this, and the Rise of Skywalker and the Skywalker saga. All right. So I'd say if you're a Star Wars fan, at least give it a look. All right. Be fair-minded and give it a look. Okay. Torrent it if you want. It ain't bad. Filoni did a really good job. Jon Favreau did a really good job. You can really see George Lucas's little fingerprints all over it too, which is great. And this isn't really even part of Star Wars that I care about. But it's interesting. So anyway, this is stuff. Setting out, see around the galaxy, see around the cantina. Please remember to tip the Wookiee bartenders 20%. No droids, no bounty hunters, no Raylos. Want to start a fight, take it out in the street. Gunfights, take this shit out in the alley. Or fights, take them out in the alley. Gunfights, take them out in the street. See around the galaxy, scoundrels.